Dear friends, we will continue as usual the lectures of beekeeping, lecture number 17 on enemies of bees. Last time we have diseases of bees. In that we have seen protozoan diseases at last. Prior to that we have seen bacterial diseases, viral diseases and likewise. Now we will see the enemies of bees. There are so many enemies in an environment which predate on bees and survive there too. So bee enemies includes, first of all, the bee parasites, which are parasites are the organisms which survive on other organisms. The bee parasites are of two types, that is external parasite and internal parasite. So first of all, we will see the external parasites, the parasites which are residing on the body of bees, and internal means the parasites which are residing in the body of bees. On the body, external parasites, and in the body, internal parasites. This is very simple. So following are the two external parasites are commonly found on the bees. There are so many, but we will see one or two for the range of syllabus according to the periods allotted for the same. First is mite, Varroa. The scientific name of mite is Varroa jacobsoni. The bee mite is tiny arachnid, belongs to the phylum Arthropoda. The female is oval, brown in color, and measures about 1 mm long and 1.5 mm wide. Whereas the male is circular with grayish white or cream coloration. The mite clings to the body of bees always from the underside of the abdomen and remains partly hidden by the overlapping segments. It pierces the intersegmental membrane and literally lives off the unfortunate bees. Female lay the eggs on the bee larvae and thus becomes sealed in the cells with developing bees. Bees infested with two or more mites appear restless as they try to free themselves from mites. The infestation of mites near the wing roots makes flight impossible or difficult. Affected bees crawl away from the hive and die. So these are the symptoms and activities of the mite infected bees. Either they found in the underside of the abdominal segments overlying there and partly hidden inside the gap between the two abdominal plates. Sternal plates are there at the ventral side, and generally they hide inside these gaps. So called as Varroa jacobsoni. This mite infestation or pradurbhava in colony causes varroosis. Abhagajantu dakhala chitra madhe varroa mite on honeybee larva 1.5 mm cha round jo asto to male asto ani elongated asa dakhala hai to female dakhala hai. It spreads with alarming rapidity and causes enormous losses of bee colony. Okay, bee cha larva evda motha ya larva var ha chota sa mite. There is no known preventive or curative methods. Yala preventive kya curative measures nahi hai mhanun ha ajar jar ka dhala ki ha pradurbhav dhala to colony nashto honala karanibhut rahana satat chalu asta nirantar chalu asta an te niyantranat yet nahi. No naked eye, two naked eyes on the capped honeycomb or honey storage cells, and the larvae are after hatching eat into wax of the caps and make tunnel through the cappings, leaving whitish and ramified mark. This result in weakening of cappings and the honey stored cells oozes out. Thus, the larvae ultimately damage the cappings of the storage cells. So this is about the mite infection to the bee, that is external parasite Varroa jacobsoni. Now, control and preventive measures. On preventive measures, some apiculturists have obtained positive results by passing flowers of sulfur through the entrance of hive. Flowers of sulfur through the entrance of hive. In Russia, investigators have reported the effectiveness of thymol vapors at the dosage of 60 to 100 milligram per hive, with an exposure time on the bees of 2 to 3 hours. Thymol has no toxic effect on the bees, but they control in some instance the infection of mites. B. Internal parasites. So this is about the external parasites. Now we will see about the internal parasites. The major internal parasites of bees are mites, found in the spiraculotracheal system and causes acarina disease. So external mites as well as internal mites are also there. So internal mite is acarina, causes acarina disease. Formalist was known as Eisel of Wick disease. So this is Wick disease. It was caused by tiny mite called as Acarapis woody. Acarine disease is caused by the internal parasite called as Acarapis woody. Rennie. It was discovered by Rennie and his associates from Great Britain. Therefore, the name is given Acarapis woody, which lives as internal parasite in the main thoracic trachea of bees. This mite feed on the body fluids of the bees. Female mite may lay eggs and further development occurs in the trachea. The trachea gets clogged with mites, means it causes obstruction in the respiratory tract, and therefore it may cause the respiratory problems, and the bees eventually dies because of suffocation in the tracheal way. The blockage of passage of air or oxygen, the bees may get dies. Infection is spread by the mites crawling out of the trachea and moving on to young worker bees and to other colonies by drifting sick bees and through infected robber bees. The disease causes heavy losses to colony. The infected bees will often crawl up on the grass, on the grass stems in front of hive, and are unable to fly. So control and preventive measures includes: the disease is controlled by exposing the affected colonies to a mixture of safrole oil 20% with nitrobenzene 40% and petrol 40%. Methyl salicylate is also used for treatment of colonies like safrole oil mixture for few days. For good prevention and curative measures, use of Holbeck's smoke strips. The smoke kills the active mites and the treatment should be again repeated for 8 to 10 days later. Each colony should be treated with either in morning or evening. So this infection can be controlled by, the mite infection can be controlled by safrole oil 20% and nitrobenzene 40% and petrol 40%. This mixture is controlling the internal parasite of the bees called as acarine parasite. So bee pest and predators. There are so many pests depending on the bees and so many predators depending on the bees are to be studied by one here. We will see bee pest is a destructive insect or other animal that attack hives and make damage to it. While the bee predator is an animal that naturally preys on bees, pest and predator of honeybee damages the colony and spreads the diseases. Honeybee has large number of enemies. Large number of bee colonies are destroyed because of the bee enemies. The good beekeeper should be aware of these all things. The bee colonies should be protected from pest and predator, and honeybees may not be get affected by a range of pests and diseases. Brief accounts of bee enemies are follows. आता बी चे एनिमीज शेकडो आहेत. सगळ्यांची नावं इथे घेता येणार नाही, परंतु आपण काही मोजके जे जास्तीत जास्त अफेक्ट करतात मधमाशीच्या पोळ्यांना त्यांची नावं घेऊया. बघूया आपण बी पेस्ट. आपल्या भारतामध्ये वेगवेगळे बी पेस्ट आहेत. आता मॉथ्स म्हणतो आपण, वॅक्स मॉथ, पतंग म्हणतो आपण त्याला. तर वॅक्स मॉथ हा सगळ्यात जास्त प्रमाणात प्रादुर्भाव करणारा कीटक आहे मधमाशीच्या पोळ्यांना. इन आवर कंट्री नॅचरल एनिमीज ऑफ हनी बी आर ॲक्टिव्ह अँड टेक हेवी टॉल ऑफ द बी लाईफ. अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ डिझर्टेशन्स पाहिजे ॲक्च्युली इथे. अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ डिझर्टेशन्स ऑफ हाईव्ज बाय बीज आर ड्यू टू द पेस्ट लाईक मॉथ्स ऑर अ वॅक्स मॉथ. डिस्ट्रक्शन्स पाहिजे लिहिलं तरी चालेल. ओके, वॉट एव्हर इट मे बी द मिनिंग. परंतु बी पेस्टमुळे सगळ्यात जास्त नुकसान मधमाशीच्या पोळ्यांना होत असेल तर ते वॅक्स मॉथ या कीटकामुळे होतं. हा वॅक्स मॉथला खायला वॅक्स लागतं आणि तो वॅक्सच्या पोळ्यामध्ये सहजपणे अंडी घालून देतो आणि मग तिथंच ते सगळ्या पोळ्याला कुरतडत फिरतात आणि म्हणून त्यांना वॅक्स मॉथ म्हणतात. मॉथ्स आर इन्सेक्ट्स. सेव्हरल काइंड्स ऑफ मॉथ्स हॅव फाउंड हॅझार्डस टू द हनीबी. टू काइंड्स ऑफ वॅक्स मॉथ्स आर फाउंड. फर्स्ट इज रॉबर अँड सेकंड इज ब्रीडर. So robber is infecting and second is breeding inside the comb. So death head hawk moth. Acherontia stax is the scientific name of that moth, which is the most dangerous robber. This moth enters into hive during the night time and drinks up the honey. If the bee colony is strong, it can be driven out, but if the colony is weak, it can be tolerated in hive. It is called minor pest and commonly called as lesser wax moth. Two species of breeder wax moth are the greater wax moth, Galeria melonella, and lesser wax moth, that is Acroia grisella. Both the species are pest of active hives. Adult moths are brownish gray in color, measures 10 to 18 mm in length, and their wing expansion is 40 mm from side to side. Females are larger than the males. So these are the identification marks of the hawk moth, generally known as Galleria melonella and Acroia grisella. These are the two species of breeder wax moth. So bee pest includes Day's hedgehog moth, greater wax moth, and leisure wax moth. So these are the three moths: Day's hedgehog moth, known as Acherontia styx. Second is the greater wax moth, known as Galleria melonella, triangular, and like somewhat looking like cockroach, laser wax moth, Acroia grisella. So these are the three species of pest infecting the bee colony. The life cycle of both species consists of four stages, that is eggs, larva, pupa, and adult moths. Both the moths lay eggs in the combs, which hatch into small larvae. The larvae burrows through the wax. It feeds on pollens and weaving tunnels. The burrowing process causes damage to the cells of broodcomb and honeycomb, damages the caps of the comb, and destroys the comb. In broodcomb, damage to the cells can sometimes result in bald brood. Bald brood occurs from wax moth larvae and partly removing cell caps when burrowing through the comb. So worker bees then chew the remainder of the capping and fully expose the heads of the bee pupae, which can lead to deformed legs or wings in newly formed adult bees. In a severe infestation, further brood rearing is stopped and colony deserts in its home and constructs the new home. The most effective method for protecting against wax moth is the use of fumigant perdichlorobenzene in stored combs gives protection. All the debris, wastage, ghaan should be cleaned up. Ata control measures baghuya. Control and preventive measures. On preventive measures, the strong colonies can be increased by keeping the hive tight fitting and by sealing the cracks and crevices with a mixture of resin and peat. Hive entrance should be reduced to weeds, which can be easily guarded by the bees. During colony examination, the gnawed pieces of comb, fallen wax scales, loose pollen pellets, and dead bees, etc., should be scraped out from the colony or from the bee box. The infected comb should be removed. Otherwise, the infection may spread to the other combs or frames. For control measures, the fumigation is the best method, and it can be done with following chemicals: a mixture of calcium cyanide, carbonate disulfide, ethylene dichloride, carbon tetrachloride with methyl bromide is used as a fumigant or a chemical to control the infection of the bee colonies. Fumigation by using methyl bromide is highly useful as it kills all stages of this pest. The combs should be stored in moth-tight hive bodies after fumigation. Then spread paradichlorobenzene crystals on the top of hive. Naphthalene flakes can also be used to control the infection of these moths or the flies or the insects. And in this way, by using the maintenance and cleanliness in the colony and by using the mixture of various chemicals or fumigants, we can control the infection of pest, particularly the wax moth, in the colonies, which are not only destroying the comb cells but also destroying the brood cells, then formed different comb cells and the wax cappings of the larvae. Ultimately, the larvae may infect and may cause the disturbances there too to the colony, and in this way we can use the control measures to the colony. So the next topic is the predators of the bee colonies or honeybees, that we will see in the next period. So till then we will continue, we will control our topic here and we will concise the measures here. Okay, see you for the next.